Now let's talk about the art of Natasha Vlasenko. The virtuosity, the courage, and everything.
This may be, hopefully, the grandest moment, or a grand moment, for classical music.
Natasha Vlasenko has performed in Russia, Italy, Germany, Austria, Japan, New Zealand, China, Australia, Hong Kong, Taiwan, Vietnam, and other countries. She has performed under the batons of many conductors such as Karl Martin, Mikhail Pletnev, Vladimir Verbitsky, Richard Hickox, and John Kuro. She has recorded a number of CDs in Russia and Australia and is a distinguished artist on the Master Performers record label. Natasha Vlasenko was born in Moscow, Soviet Russia, to pianist Lev Nikolaevich Vlasenko and English teacher Mikhaila Yakovlevna Krutatovska. Vlasenko was a graduate of the Moscow Central Music School under Eleonora Musoyan. She studied in the Moscow Conservatory under the famous pianist and teacher Yakov Flier. After his death, she continued her postgraduate studies in the class of Flier's pupil, Professor Lev Vlasenko. She began her artistic career as a soloist of the Moscow Philharmonia. She commenced her pedagogic activities as a piano teacher in the Central Music School. In 1977, she won third prize at the International Beethoven Competition in Vienna. In 1985, she went on to win third prize at the Ferruccio Busoni International Piano Competition in Bolzano, Italy. My fellow Australians and citizens of the world, would you believe that Lev Vlasenko's daughter, Natasha Vlasenko, is now living and working in Australia? She is head of keyboard at the Queensland Conservatorium, Griffith University. Many of her students have become prize winners of national and international piano competitions and professors in music schools in the United States, Ireland, and Australia. In 1999, Vlasenko and her husband, Oleg Stepanov, co-founded the Lev Vlasenko Piano Competition in memory of her father, Lev Vlasenko. Vlasenko and Stepanov have since taken up the roles of artistic directors of the piano competition. The competition is the only major piano event in Australia that mirrors the requirements of an international piano competition and is held in Brisbane every 2 years since 1999. In 2018, Natasha Vlasenko appeared with the Russian National Orchestra for the fourth time under Mikhail Pletnev, performing Mozart's double piano concerto with Eliso Vasilatse piano. Let's hear Natasha Vlasenko with Lev Vlasenko playing the concerto in E flat major for two pianos and orchestra, K365. And we're going to hear the Rondo Allegro, which is the finale. Thank you. That was Natasha Vlasenko with Lev Vlasenko playing the concerto in E flat major for two pianos and orchestra, K365. That recording is available on Apple Music. You can buy it from Apple Music or stream it on their platform. Today, I'm very deeply honored to have Natasha Vlasenko as our guest. Incredibly uplifting playing, Natasha. It's also a very good sound quality. Where was this recording made?
That was made in Moscow, and it was also very famous conductor, Gennady Rozhdestvensky, with him. That was in Moscow in mid-90s, I think, somewhere. No, probably even earlier. Don't quite remember. Long time ago.
Was it easy to play with your father, or was it difficult?
Look, it was very nice, actually, because I regret that that's actually the only recording and performance we have done together. Unfortunately, we were planning to do more, but it just wasn't possible for many reasons. It was very nice to play together because I think we have some similar qualities, probably, in our approach to music, so I think the understanding was complete all throughout it.
Yes, the ensemble was superb. It's very clear and beautiful playing.
Thank you.
Now let's listen to Natasha Vlasenko's 2010 recording of Franz Schubert's Four Impromptus, Opus 90, D89, number 4 in A flat, Allegretto. Thank you. That was Natasha Vlasenko's 2010 recording of Franz Schubert's Four Impromptus, Opus 90, D899, number 4, A flat, Allegretto. Natasha, you know my father, William Hennessy AO, probably better known as Bill Hennessy, is the founding member of the Australian String Quartet and currently the concertmaster of the Melbourne Chamber Orchestra. Do you know Sir Murray Pariah and Sir Neville Mariner's recording of the Mozart Piano Concerti?
Yes, of course I know that recording. Yes.
My father was working in London under Sir Neville Mariner. Pariah, Mariner and Dad made those recordings together. Anyway, when Dad heard your recording of the Schubert Impromptus, he said he preferred your recording to Sir Murray Pariah's recording of the same work.
Oh, that's nice to hear. Yeah, I think it's quite a good recording.
The Bagatelles, Opus 33 for solo piano, were composed by Ludwig von Beethoven in 1801 to 1802. The seven bagatelles are quite typical of Beethoven's early style, retaining many compositional features of the early classical period. Let's hear Natasha Vlasenko playing all seven of the bagatelles.
Thank you.
That was Natasha Vlasenko playing the Bagatelles Opus 33 for solo piano. And that recording is available on the Master Performers label. You can listen to it on Apple Music by streaming it on Apple Music, and it can be purchased by going to store.cdbaby.com/CD/Natasha Vlasenko. Natasha, I also noticed that you made an inspired and daring decision to program a lesser-known work, the Fantasia in G minor, Opus 77 by Beethoven.
Yes, Fantasia, it's not very often played. It's kind of an experimental work, like improvisation. But it shows Beethoven, you know, in the working process, like a laboratory. He sits down and improvises something. Different ideas come to him. I think that he brings it all together in a very spontaneous kind of a way. It's interesting work, I think.
During his early years, Beethoven's powers of improvisation were legendary. As Czerny later recalled, quote, "His improvisation was most brilliant and striking. In whatever company he might chance to be, he knew how to produce an effect upon every hearer that frequently not an eye remained dry, while many would break out into loud sobs. For there was something wonderful in his expression, in addition to the beauty and originality of his ideas and his spirited style of rendering them. After ending an improvisation of this kind, he would burst out into loud laughter and mock his listeners for the emotion he had caused them. 'You are fools,' he would say." According to Misha Donat, no piece of Beethoven affords a more vivid picture of what his improvisations must have been like than this Fantasia in G minor, Opus 77, by Beethoven. Let's hear Natasha Vlasenko's recording of it.
Thank you.
That was Natasha Vlasenko performing Beethoven's Fantasia in G minor, opus 77, for solo piano. It was a very good piano sound that he captured. He must have been a very experienced engineer. I really enjoyed that album, and I have listened to it many times, so thank you for that.
Thank you.
And the album is Natasha Vlasenko, Distinguished Artists. The label is Master Performers, and the recording is by Lodestar Recordings. Recording and digital editing and mastering was by David Spearitt. That's SPEARRITT. And David writes in the disc, quote, absolutely no compression or alteration or dynamic range employed in mastering. Perhaps that's the reason why we had such an exceptional sound quality on that recording. The album Natasha Vlasenko, Master Performers Distinguished Artists, was released on the Master Performers label in 2010 and is now available on Apple Music and elsewhere. Just Google it. It's a unique and very special offering that features a rarely performed or recorded Fantasia in G minor, opus 77 by Beethoven, and explores connections between Beethoven's Bagatelles, opus 33, and the Schubert Impromptus, opus 90, D899. This album is a must-have item for anyone who wishes to familiarize themselves with one of the greatest living musicians on Australian soil. If you wish to buy the album, please follow the link we've provided on the 5MBS Facebook page.
This may be, hopefully, the grandest moment, or a grand moment, for classical music.